Welcome everyone, we'll get started shortly. Welcome everyone, welcome, welcome. Hey guys, welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly. Welcome Daniel, welcome Zaire, welcome.
Thank you, thank you.
Hey Jane, welcome, welcome. Guys, we'll get started shortly. Welcome guys, welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly here. Hope everyone's having a good week. Welcome, welcome. Welcome, welcome guys. We'll get started shortly.
Recording in progress.
Welcome guys. Hey, I won. Welcome, welcome. Guys, we'll get started shortly. Welcome guys, welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly here.
Bye.
All right, guys, we'll go ahead and get started. Can everyone see my shared screen? It should say trading in the zone. Does everyone see that? Do you guys see my shared screen there? Trading in the zone. Can you guys hear me okay? Hello?
Yes, I can hear you.
You guys can hear me? Okay.
Yes.
Hey, Daniel, can you see my screen there, my shared screen?
Yes, I can see it.
Okay. Okay, guys, welcome. As you guys know, this evening, we do a class every evening. This evening is for new traders. So traders, individuals that are just getting into trading, whether you've taken just a few trades or haven't taken any trades at all, we're going to go over some of the basic principles that you need to be aware of when getting into this business we call trading. Okay, so I want to welcome you guys. Welcome you guys here. That screen that you guys see there, that shared screen, you should see where it says trading in the zone. Trading in the zone. I highly recommend this book. All right. I highly recommend this book, especially for new traders. Okay. Especially for new traders. This book is perhaps one of the best books written on trading psychology. Okay, on trading psychology. All right, so take a picture of it, write it down. We use this book when we do our one-on-one coaching. So we do one-on-one coaching with our traders, and we use this book as a reference, as a guide. Okay, so it's called Trading in the Zone. Trading in the Zone, Master the Market with Confidence, Discipline, and a Winning Attitude. Very, very critical, guys, when we trade. Most new traders, they assume that they can get into these markets, all right, pick up a few tips and start trading and start making lots of money. And they realize quickly that that's not the case, all right? So your mindset, guys, is perhaps, I would say, 90% of your work. All right. So all the work that's going to be done to be a successful trader, that's going to be done with your mindset. All right. You'll need certain tools. You'll need to understand the principles of trading, but your mindset, right? Master the market with confidence, discipline, and a winning attitude. That is critical. All right, so I recommend on YouTube, there is an audio book. All right, it's a free audio book. If you're serious about trading and getting into trading, I highly recommend, at least when you're done with me this evening, go on, get on YouTube, start listening to the audio book, Trading in the Zone. All right, Trading in the Zone. The next book I'm going to recommend is Trend Following. Okay. Trend Following. All right. Do you guys see it there? Trend Following?
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. So write this down. Trend Following. How to make a fortune in bull, bear, and black swan markets. Okay, this is one of the best books written on trading. Okay, and how to make money in up and down markets, in any markets. And the way we make money is by following trends, right? So we want to take small losses, big wins. We only get big wins by following trends. So Trend Following by Michael Koval. Very good book. we give this book, we provide trading systems to our traders. So when traders get our trading systems, we give them this book for free. Trend following. Okay, very, very good resource. Okay, so those are the two books we highly recommend for traders. All right. All right. Okay, I've got another screen here. You guys see this? It's called the four market phases. And I want to make sure that I'm sharing the right screens here with you guys. That's why I'm confirming the screens here. Do you guys see this? The four market phases?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. I want you guys to take a picture of this. All right. Take a picture of it. I would recommend you guys print it and laminate it for your records. This is the four market phases that every trader must know. The four market phases that every trader must know. All right. Every stock, every crypto, every futures, every Forex, every single security will have to follow these steps, guys. So we must know the four phases, okay? From accumulation at the bottom here. So one, accumulation phase, the accumulation phase. Phase two is the markup phase. Okay, phase two is the markup phase. Within the markup phase, there's reaccumulation. Okay, so we would be buying in the markup phase. Then distribution, number three. Okay, distribution. That's usually when the stock or the currency pair makes a turn. All right, makes a turn. Can't go any higher, all right? And starts to go down. We call that the markdown phase, okay? We call that the markdown phase. And within the markdown phase, we have redistribution. So we need to know what these four phases are. So take picture of this and keep it for your records, all right? Everyone has that? You guys got it?
Yes, we do.
All right. Okay. The next thing we want to talk about is support and resistance. Okay. Support and resistance. Do you guys see my shared screen here? Support and resistance?
No.
No? Okay. All right. Let's try this again. One second here. All right, do you guys see it now? It should say at the top, support and resistance.
Yes, we do.
Okay, so the keys to your success, so resistance at the top, that green line, and support at the bottom, that red line. Very, very, very critical. Okay, very, very critical to your success. All right. So let's have a conversation. I want to have a conversation with you guys. All right. Who hasn't taken a trade? Who hasn't taken a trade? Who hasn't taken a trade? So everyone has taken a trade?
No.
Okay. So you haven't taken a trade at all?
Not at all.
Not at all. Okay. Who has taken, who has been trading less than a year? Less than a year?
Me, less than a year.
Less than a year? Okay, Jane. Okay, very good. Okay, guys. The way I do this here is we're just going to have a conversation, okay? So I want to get an idea of your level of experience, okay? Areas that you guys want to learn about, okay, things that you might have heard out there about trading, That might be good or bad, okay? And I'm gonna go through some, I'm gonna give you guys some really good nuggets that you can take with you this evening, okay? I want you guys to stop me, don't be shy, all right? So this class is for beginning traders only. We do not have any experienced traders on this call, okay? So don't feel intimidated at all. I know sometimes traders with a lot of experience can be a bit intimidating, okay? So that's why I started this class so that you guys can feel safe to ask any questions, okay? So I want you guys to stop me at any time. This information is very, very important for new traders. Okay, so I want you guys to write this down, and I'm gonna do this here. I'm going to share my screen, my trading screen, so you guys can get a real-time knowledge of what we're talking about here. All right, so you should have the four market phases. You should have a picture of that. You should save it. That's, you should have a picture of support and resistance, and then the books that we recommend. Okay. All right. Who out there know, have you guys heard of support and resistance? Has anyone out there heard of support and resistance?
Yes.
Okay, so tell me what support and resistance is. What is support and resistance?
Support is where you open an order, and resistance is where you want it to close.
Okay, support is where you want to open an order. So support is where you want to buy.
Where you put the buy order,
okay,
or your market, and then the resistance will be where you thinking that, you know, it will be a good place to close it. That will be your resistance.
Okay, very good.
That's what I heard.
Okay, all right. I'm going to show you how to think a little bit different. Okay, this is how most traders think, though. I'm glad you mentioned that. Right. So most traders, they looking to buy at support and then get out at resistance, okay? So I'm gonna show you a different way of thinking about that. You're not totally incorrect, okay? But there's a better way to do it, all right? Anyone else? What do you guys think support and resistance is? And the reason why I open with support and resistance is because that's going to be critical, all right? And you're right, this is where we're gonna buy and where we're gonna sell. So we're gonna all our buying and selling will be based on support and resistance. So it's very, very important that we understand support and resistance, okay? Anyone else? Okay, write this down. Okay, so when we trade, write this down. We're gonna buy at resistance. We're gonna buy, so it's the reverse. We're gonna buy at resistance, sell at support. Write it down. We are going to buy at resistance, and we're going to sell at support. So we're going to enter when the price breaks resistance, and we are going to sell when the price breaks support. So what you mentioned earlier, we're gonna buy at support and sell at resistance. That's what most traders do, but we don't want to do that. Okay, we want to do the opposite. We want to buy at resistance, sell at support. Why do you guys think we want to buy at resistance or sell at support? Do you guys know what support and resistance is? Does anyone know?
No, I don't know.
Okay. I'm glad you said that, okay? Because it's important that we know what support and resistance is. So I want you guys to think of support and resistance like this. This is an easy analogy. This is the best analogy that I know how to use, okay, for new traders. So where you are right now in your home, just think of your floor, right? So the floor that you're standing on right now, that's your support, all right? So it's supporting you, right? That's your support. So your floor is your support, all right? Your ceiling, that's your resistance, okay? So the floor, your floor is your support. Your ceiling is your resistance. Okay, so let me do this again. Let me bring in the support and resistance chart here. Okay, you guys see the support and resistance chart? You guys see the chart here? Yes. Help me out. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so it's support, that red line at the bottom, that's your support. So that's your floor. The green line at the top, that's resistance. Okay? And the way price works is like this. The middle lines in the middle there, that's your price. So just think of it like this is Apple or Bitcoin or whatever, right? And every time the price gets to resistance, there are buyers there. So there are buyers sitting at that resistance line, and then there are sellers sitting at that resistance line. Okay, so we call them shorts. So the short sellers are looking to bring the price back down to support. And at support, okay, you've got buyers are looking to bring the price back up. So there's a battle between buyers and sellers at resistance and at support. Within that area, that's our consolidation or accumulation or distribution. Okay? You guys follow me?
Yes.
Okay. So I want you guys to think about this now. At resistance, price does not just randomly move. Price doesn't randomly move. Your stock doesn't randomly move. Okay, there are big hedge funds, big institutions, big market makers, okay, that are moving the price. And all these traders are looking for levels. They're watching resistance and they're watching support. So the buyers or the longs, we call them longs, they're looking to break resistance, okay? And the short sellers are looking to break support. So when the price breaks resistance, the buyers win, okay? And our price will move to the upside. Our job is to buy at resistance. So when the buyers come on as retail, we are retail investors or retail traders, guys. We don't trade enough volume to move the price. Only the big institutions, only the big hedge funds, only the big market makers can move the stock or the crypto, okay? Or the Forex or whatever it is. So we have to wait for the price to break resistance. Okay, follow me. So we have to wait for the price to break resistance so that we've got confirmation that the buyers are in. When we know the buyers are in, that's when we get in. So we want to buy. We don't want to buy at support. Okay, what could happen if we buy at support? What could happen if we buy at support?
Lose your money?
We could lose money how?
If it goes down.
Yeah, go ahead. Sorry, bro.
No, that's fine. If it goes lower, that's the risk.
Okay, and why is that? Who is in control? Who is in control at support?
Sellers.
The sellers. Very good. All right, so if the price breaks support, the sellers are in control. Okay, so remember this. We want to be buying at resistance. Most new traders, guys, learn this the wrong way, right? They always buy at support and sell at resistance. And what they're hoping is that, what they're hoping is this. Let me show you guys here. Can you guys see my trading screen here?
Yes, Dave.
Okay, very good. Okay. So here's an example here. Here's an example here. Let me find. All right. This is Bitcoin here. And most people, you guys are familiar with Bitcoin. All right. So I want to show you guys a real live example here. Okay. So these lines here, guys, these lines here are our support and resistance lines. Okay, so these lines here are support and resistance lines. Okay, remember, we want to buy at resistance because guess what? Who's in control? If we buy at resistance and the price breaks resistance,
who won?
The buyers won. Very good. So the buyers want.
So, the buyers.
Yes. So we want to buy when the buyers are buying. So these green candles here, price broke resistance, we bought. All right. We want to sell on a break of support. Okay. So the price broke support right here. Right here is when the price broke support. So we want to be selling. So here is where the price broke support right here. So we want to sell, we want to get out, okay? And look what happened after we got out, when the sellers come in. When the sellers come in, guys, red candles, the sellers come in, they're going to bring the price back down, okay? Here is support and resistance, just like your chart here, look. Look at this, follow me for a second. I know this is new, but this is what we've got to learn as new traders. Okay, here is, forget about this right here. Forget about this. Here is support and resistance, right? Here is support and resistance. Most traders buy at the bottom here, at support. We don't want to do that. We want to wait for the price to break resistance. Green candles, we know the buyers are in, right? And we want to buy. We want to be buying in this area here. That's called the markup phase. Price broke support right here. We got a sell signal to get out. So buy at resistance, sell at support. Buy at resistance. There's another resistance here. Buy at resistance right here, right? But buyers are in control. The buyers are in control. There is support here. We're going to sell at support. So we bought here, got out here. Here's the price all the way down here. We bought here, got out here. Bought at resistance, sell at support. Bought at resistance, sell at support. Bought at resistance, sell at support. You guys see that?
Yes. And David, can you go back and explain what determines the support and the resistance?
Okay.
The candle?
Very good. Very good. Very good question. Okay. So let's do this. Very good. All right. All right. So you guys see my chart, my support and resistance chart there?
Yes.
All right. Take a picture of this now if you guys don't have it. Support and resistance is determined when the price hits an area, okay? I say at least twice. So if it reaches that same area, like resistance, the high here, the high, can you guys see my cursor?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Okay, so If it hits it twice, then we've got resistance. If it hits an area once, like right here, just once, that's just the high. But if the price comes back to that area, that's resistance. The more time, guys, it hits that area there, then we've got a stronger resistance. Same thing for support. That price has to come to that area several times, okay? And what's happening, the reason that the price is stopping at that area, okay, is because of price. And all these traders have a price in mind. So let's go back to the chart. So look here for a second. Look here for a second. Okay, this is real time, guys. This is real time. And as traders, this is what we must do. We must do this. We can't get away from it. Okay, so this purple line here is resistance. This purple line here is support, okay? No, this is real time. This is happening right now. You guys see where the price came to this level right here?
Mm-hmm.
And you see where it came to this level right here? And the system drew a line, that's our resistance. Okay, the price never went any higher. And what traders are doing, they're watching that. Right now, at that 52,000 mark, they are watching this mark. So when the price comes up to this level, the sellers are bringing it back down. And they're bringing it back down to this support right here. See where price hit right here? Price hit right here. Price is stopping right there. These are the buyers that are holding the price up. So the buyers are holding the price up. The sellers are trying to take it down. All right. That's how support and develop, and I'm sorry, support and resistance are developed. That's how they're made. Okay. So we've got to be very, very concerned with price. Okay. All these price action when it gets near support and resistance. Okay, so if we look at that support and resistance here, if we look here, and here, support and resistance right here, and it's constantly moving, guys. It's constantly moving because the market is a living, breathing thing. Support and resistance here. And what we're doing, when we're looking at charts, we're constantly looking, we're looking for the breakouts. We're looking to see where the big buyers are going to break the price, either to the upside or to the downside, okay? We're constantly looking to see where they're going to move the price next, either to the upside or to the downside, okay? If they move the price, break resistance to the upside, we'll get in. If they decide to break the price, move the price, break support to the downside, we'll get out. Okay, you guys see that?
David, probably you may do another training of what is that we buy in that break and resistance, because I know that we buy pips, but that would be another class. You explain how to open an order and close one.
That's the easy part. Opening an order, buying and entering a trade, that's the easy part. This is the hard part. This is what you guys need to get here.
Oh no, not you, baby. I ain't gonna do nothing like this.
Hello.
I'm here, David.
Okay. Did you have another question?
No. That was my question. But if you will cover that in another training, that's good. I never done this before, so that's why I'm making this question. So.
Okay.
Because I see other people doing it. I just don't know how to buy pips and stuff like that. I don't know. I don't know anything about.
Okay. Believe it or not, we can go over that. That's easy. Entering the trade, you know, we can show you how to do that. The bigger thing that you guys need to know, what really takes a lot of time, is you're having the right mindset and knowing how a price works. Okay, so knowing how a price works. All right. So I'm going to share another screen here with you guys. Okay. So can you guys see my cursor here moving around? Can you see my cursor moving around here?
Yes.
And you guys see the four market phases, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Okay, follow me for a second, guys. Follow me for a second. Okay. Every single chart that you guys will see, whether it's Forex, whether it's crypto, everything, okay, it's always going to start in the accumulation phase, phase one. Okay, going to repeat that. All right. Every chart you see, okay, there's going to be an area in your chart, even if you have to go back in history, where there is an accumulation phase. Phase one. Our job as traders is to find the accumulation. And this is how accumulation happens. This is resistance here. This is resistance. This is support. We got buyers here at resistance and sellers at resistance. We got buyers here at support and sellers at support. So think of resistance. Let's say resistance is at $100. This is $100 at resistance, $50 at support. $100 at resistance, $50 at support. All right. So the buyers are looking, are watching this price, and they're like, okay, if the price gets to $100, I'm going to jump in and I'm going to take it to 200, 300, 400, whatever that price is. The sellers, when the price gets to support, the sellers are trying to drive it down. Okay. And they're trying to get it down from 50 to 25 to 10. If the price doesn't break, listen now, if the price doesn't break support, that means the sellers have lost. If the price breaks support, the sellers have won. All right. If the price breaks resistance, the buyers have won. Okay. And then all we do is react. So, for example, follow me. Here is resistance. This line here is our price line here. The price broke resistance here. We would have bought. We would have bought. Right? So now we're riding the wave. We're riding the trend. That's called the markup phase. Price is moving up. That's the markup phase. So we would buy in on a break of resistance and we would stay in and we would add, this is reaccumulation, we would add to our position. When would we close the position? When would we sell? When would we get out? Look at your chart. When would we get out? Think about what I've said already. When would we get out? When do you guys think you would have to get out of the trade?
Distribution phase?
Who said distribution?
Daniel.
Very good, Daniel. So you see here, you guys see my cursor? All right. When the price breaks this support, okay, see, distribution phase breaks the support. Who is in control when the price breaks support?
Sellers.
The sellers. So we have to get out. Good job. Good job. You guys got this. So we're going to buy when the price breaks resistance. That means the buyers are in control. Right, so we're going to buy when the price breaks resistance, buyers are in control. We are going to sell we're not going to just sell randomly, right? Because we think we should sell. We are only going to get out when the sellers are in control. And we know that the sellers are in control when the price breaks support. So we bought here, sold here, bought at resistance, sold at support. And we made money here. We call this the meat of the trade. Where most traders try to get the bottom. That's why traders try to sell, try to buy at support. You can't buy at support because the buyers are not in control. So that's where most traders get in trouble. They want to buy at support and sell at resistance. They're doing it the wrong way. We need to be buying at resistance when the price breaks resistance. We want to be buying when the buyers are in control and sell at support. Most traders,
what do you say?
Go ahead.
So what do you say when they say buy low, sell high? That's kind of wrong, right?
It's kind of wrong. Very good. Very good. Very good. We will never sell, we will never buy low and sell high.
It's the opposite, right?
Yeah. We'll never buy low. This is the low here. This is the low here. Okay? But our buy here, the buyers are not in control, right? Mm-hmm. And in this area here, no one is in control, right? So if we bought here and sold here, okay, we call that the meat of the trade. Okay, so most people think, well, I want to buy low and sell high. No, you never buy low and sell high. Here is the high. Here is the high. Here is the low. We're going to buy here, sell here, buy here, sell here. We're going to get the meat of the trade. Okay, so we want the meat of the trade. So if we look here, for example, let me find a good example here. One second here. Good job. Good job. All right. Let's get this. Let's get a good example here. All right. Here's a decent example here. Look at this here. And we can go through many charts and you guys will notice it right away. All right. And these are exercises you can do when you look at charts. Okay. Just remember, buy at resistance, sell at support. Buy at resistance, sell at support. Okay. So follow me. So here is a Forex pair. Doesn't matter what it is. So here is our low. Here is our low here. We didn't buy low, right? We didn't buy low and sell high, right? We didn't buy at the bottom here. We bought when the price broke resistance up here. We didn't sell. So this blue arrow here, guys, this blue arrow, this triangle right here was our buy signal. This white arrow here was our sell signal, okay? So buy signal here, right here, sell signal right here. We didn't buy at the low here at support, and we didn't buy at the high here, okay? We bought when the price broke resistance. So that told us that, hey, the buyers are in control. It wasn't until the price broke resistance, right, that we knew that the buyers are in control. We didn't sell at the top here because guess what? The sellers are not in control. The buyers are still in control. And guess what? The price could move higher, right? Just like here. It kept moving higher. It kept moving higher, right? So we have to wait until the price breaks support, all right? We get red candles and now we'll get out of the trade. So we don't get the absolute bottom and we don't get the absolute top, right? Because we need confirmation that the buyers are in and we need confirmation that the sellers are in. So we get the meat. This is considered the meat of the trade. From here to here is the meat of the trade. And that's good enough. That's good enough. What would happen if we try to get the very top? What would happen if we try to get the top, get out at the top here? At the top here, what could happen, guys? What could happen? What could happen if we got out of the trade at the top here? We don't wait for a break of support. We get out right here. What could happen? There are no wrong answers. What could happen? There's just a really good answer. What could happen if we get out here and not wait for a break of support to get out here? What could happen?
It's a good question. I would say you can capitalize most of your money. Oh, you said not get out at the top. Is that what you just said? Sorry, can you ask that question again?
Yeah. What could happen if we got out here at the top? If we try to get out, if we don't wait for a break of support and we got out of the trade at the top here?
Oh, then you can risk losing more money from breaking a new resistance.
Yeah, so we could risk not making more money because it could continue to break resistance like it did here, right? Continue in the reaccumulation phase. All right, so I want you guys to think about this. In trading, right? The way we make money in trading is we want to cut our losing trades quickly. So write this down. In trading, we want to cut our losing trades quickly and we want to stay in our winning trades as long as possible. So we want to get out of the losing trades quickly and then we want to stay in the winning trades as long as possible. Most traders do the opposite, right? So most traders, they'll get out of their losing trades quickly and then they'll stay in their losing trades. You guys hear that, right? So we want to stay in our winning trades as long as possible. And then we want to get out of our losing trades quickly. Because we need our winning trades. We need to stay in the winning trades as long as possible because we need those profits to cover our losses, our small losses on our losing trades. So if we get out here, because we assume that the price will not go any higher, or we get out here, or we got out here, or we get out here, we're taking small profits. We need to take big wins, small losses, right? We know that the trade is over. The trade is only over when the price breaks support. It never breaks support here. It never breaks support here. It never breaks support here. It was only here that it broke support, right here. And that's when we get out. So we can get nice big wins, small losses. And that's how we make money. It's a game of math, pure math. Okay, pure math. Any questions on this? This is your chance, guys. Any questions on this? We have to do this as traders. There's no getting around it. You guys have to learn this and you have to do it this way. There's no other way. We want to buy at resistance when the buyers are have taken control of the price, and all we're doing is we're piggybacking on that move. So we want to be buying when they're selling. Our only trigger is a break of resistance. We want to sell on a break of support when they're done. When they're done buying and they get out, we want to get out. And this is critical. Here is an example here, guys. Okay, and this is what happens when we don't follow this. And if you guys haven't traded before and you want to get into trading, it can be extremely painful if you don't know what you're doing and if you don't follow this concept. It's that important. So here is the pound yen, and it doesn't matter. This will happen with it doesn't matter. Okay, so the price broke resistance here. We got a buy signal here to get out. The price went up, failed, didn't turn into a trend. It broke support. Here is support right here. Here is support. And this is a violent move. Price came back down. We got a sell signal to get out. Okay, we took a small loss here, but it saved us from all this down here. Let me repeat. Here was our buy signal. The buyers are in, right? Price turned around because we can't control price, okay? Price broke support. Here is our support line right here. Broke support. We have to sell at support. We've got to get out. Here is our signal to get out. Liquidate long position. Get out. And guess what? Look what happened to price. Came all the way down. If we hadn't gotten out on a break of support, guess what? We would sustain this loss right here. Here is another example. Price broke resistance. So here is support there. Here is resistance. Price broke resistance. We got a buy signal. Price went up a little higher. Guess what? Price broke support, failed. We got a sell signal to get out. Look what happened. Okay. Price broke resistance. Look here. Price broke resistance here now. Are you guys following me? This makes sense. You guys see this?
Yes, I see it.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. I'm seeing it.
Very good. So here, price broke resistance right here. Here is your support and resistance down here. It's important you guys get this. If you're looking to trade,
and David, later on you will explain when it's time to sell. You know, in this case, will be you selling your peps, I guess, at that price, on the
yes.
time of.
Yeah, so just
the signal.
Yeah, just think of, okay, so what you want to think of is just exit, okay?
Just exit, okay.
Just exit. So entry and exit. Entry, okay. And exit.
Buy is entry and selling is exit.
Is exit, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so.
Not really that you selling something or selling, you know, something at a certain price. It's just like yeah. exit it out.
Yeah, don't worry about that. Don't worry about it. Just entry. That's the biggest thing for traders. Where do I get in? But most importantly, guys, okay, where do I get out? Okay. Right. That's the most critical thing. Where do we get in? Okay, not at what price. Not at what price. Where on the chart? Okay. Where mm-hmm. on the chart do we get in? And where on the chart do we get out? That's the critical aspect when it comes to trading. Where do I get in and where do I get out? Even if you're lucky to get in at the right place, let's say break of resistance, if you don't know where to get out, right? That's critical to your success. Okay. So write this down again. Your entry is always going to be on a break of resistance. And your exit is going to be a break of support. A break of resistance means the buyers are in control. We want to be buying when they're buying. Right? It's like if we don't buy when they're buying, it's like driving in the US on the left hand, on the right hand side. You're going against the traffic. Right? You're going against the traffic. So if you are, let's say for instance, right here, if you are not buying, right? If you're not buying when they're buying, in here, they're buying here, green candles. This is in the markup phase. It's breaking resistance. If you're not buying when they're buying, you're not gonna make any money. If you're buying here, so someone said buy low and sell high, right? So follow me for a second. Okay, so let's say, for instance, this price right here. This price right here, this high, you know what? Let's use Bitcoin. Bitcoin is popular right now. So let's use Bitcoin. Okay. Okay, do you guys think, so this is 65,000 right here. Do you guys think there were people out there that bought Bitcoin at 65,000? Do you guys think there are people out there that bought Bitcoin when Bitcoin hit 65,000?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
I believe there's people that did that mistake, but.
Okay, all right. Do you think there are people out there that bought Bitcoin at 60,000?
Yes.
Okay. Do you guys think that there are people out there that bought Bitcoin at 55,000?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Do you guys think there are people out there that bought Bitcoin at 49,000.
Absolutely.
Okay. Do you guys think there are people out there who are buying Bitcoin right now at 46,000?
Yes.
Okay. How do you think the people who bought at 65,000, how do you think they feel right now with the price at 46,000?
Disappointed. Totally disappointed.
Yeah. How do you guys think the people that bought at 60,000, how do you think they feel right now? Right? How about the folks that bought at 55,000 and now it's at 46,000? And I want you guys, as we go through these examples, think of you. All right? Think of the fact that this is you in the trade and you bought at 65,000 and now it's at $46,000. What if it comes down to $40,000? How would you feel? How would you feel if you bought it now? This is your hard-earned money. And you bought at $65,000, and now it's at $40,000. All right? And now this is real money now, right? And now, guess what? It's at $30,000. You bought it at $65,000, and now it's at $30,000. Now let's say this, because we can't control price. We can't control price. It's going to do what it's going to do. So let's say it comes down all the way down to 20,000. You bought it at 65. You guys have heard stories. You've heard stories like this, right? You bought it at 65 and now it's at 20,000. That's not what we want to do. Guess what? The sellers are out here. We want to buy at resistance, sell at support. So let me show you guys this here. Look at this. Follow me. This is why we have to learn this and do this. If you do it any other way, it's going to be frustrating. And in trading, when it's frustrating, guess what? In like any other game of golf or whatever, right? It's frustrating. You might get frustrated. You might waste a day. But in trading, if we don't do this the right way, we lose money. So here, break of resistance, we want to be buying. A break of support, we want to get out. So we want to buy there, sell here. Let the price come down. Let them do what they've got to do. This is the markdown phase. We let it go down as low as possible. This is how we want to buy low and sell high, right? This is buying low and sell high. Here, price here, broke resistance right here. We wait for them to show us that the selling is over. It held support. Okay, it held support. The selling is over. Guess what? The buying is now in. We bought here. Hit support. We got out here. We wait. We just wait. Here, broke resistance again. The buyers are back in here. We bought here. Sold here. Price hits support right here. The sellers are back in. Right? So the sellers are back in. We get out. So we made money here. Made money here, made money here, and now we're out. So while everyone else is holding, guess what? We've made money here, made money here, made money here, and now we're waiting. Rather than buying here, okay? Or we bought here and we're hoping that in some time in the future that Bitcoin will go back up to 65,000. Because guess what? If the price breaks this support here, what could happen if the price breaks this support line right here? What could happen? What could happen?
It goes even lower and it makes a whole new support again.
It goes even lower and it makes a whole new support again. So that's in the markdown phase. Right now, Bitcoin is in the markdown phase. Okay. Mm-hmm. If it breaks it breaks support, this red line right here, it's going to go down further. Just like it did on the left side when it went up, it can do the same thing on the way down. So we've got to wait for it to build accumulation somewhere in the bottom, okay? And then we can get back in. So we don't just randomly get in the markets, guys, and buy. right? We don't just randomly get in and just buy. And we just don't randomly get out and sell. All right. Pretty cool stuff, right? Isn't this pretty cool? Yeah, this is pretty cool stuff, right? As new traders, I wish I knew this when I first started trading. I've been trading for over 25 years. I've been doing this for a long time. If someone had told me that this is how the markets work, right, when I started, boy, it would have saved me a lot of frustration, right? You guys are fortunate because you're getting this information, whether you implement it or not, right? Whether you become traders or not, doesn't matter. You understand how price works. We're in this trade right now. We've got traders in this trade, pound yen. Here was our buy signal right here. And we have traders that are in this trade. You guys come back and, you know, we have a class on we have a class every evening. Our crypto and Forex class is on Sunday, all right? And you guys will hear of traders that are in this trade. They bought here on a break of resistance right here. Here is our buy signal right here. And guess what? They're still in this trade. And this is a nice trade, right? They didn't get out. They're holding. They keep adding to their position as the price keeps going higher. It's in the markup phase. There's nothing to worry about. It's not until the sellers come in, like here, we get a sell signal on a break of support, we'll get out so that we don't have losses like this. This is really cool for new traders, because the biggest concern with new traders is, where do I get in? Where do I enter? And where do I get out? So the four market phases will guide you. The four market phases, from accumulation to markup to distribution to markdown, okay? And then within the markup phase, reaccumulation. This is reaccumulation right here, okay? And our traders did this. They added here. Every time reaccumulation means, guess what? They're buying again, they're buying again, they're buying again. Once they're done buying, price breaks support somewhere in the future, we'll get a sell signal, get out, take our profits, and wait for the next trade.
For this trade here, Dave, what would you say is the sell signal? Like right now, let's say, for example, if something was to happen that the sellers got in, when would you say that you should get out in this trade? Just an example.
Okay, so when would you get out, Daniel? When do you think you would get out? You would get out of the trade, close the trade.
I would say, if I'm looking at numbers, because I don't want to say words, because it's the easy way out. But I would say probably at 155.7, like the next. That's what I'm thinking, but I might be wrong. So it'll be 155 where your black marker is, 155.740.
So you're trying to find a support?
Yeah, kind of what I leave. I mean, I guess it would be there where I would leave, I think, because that's where it would be where I purchased. Because you said if your traders, they were building a new support and they bought a resistance, which was a little bit high, 155, and then it built another one, and then they bought at 155.7740 or something. So 155, but that's when they bought again. I'm just trying to read the graph, that's all.
Okay.
So
I think
Was there another question?
No, I think the answer of that will be when they start creating a distribution phase again.
And then does what?
And then start marking down, you know, like, and it will give us a signal to sell. That's when you get out.
To sell where?
And the distribution phase.
But it has to do what? Break what?
It has to break resistance. It has to break, not resistance, it has to break, I forgot the word. I'm sorry.
When it starts to redistribute again, when it starts to create another redistribution, so it's on its way down. Creating another redistribution.
I think. And it has to break. It has to break what?
Support again.
Has to break support. Very support. Good. That's the word.
That's yep. It.
It has to break support. That's very when good. You get so out. Dave.
Yeah, very good.
What I'm
yeah.
saying is, can you give us like a make believe example of when would that happen? Like. Let's just say a probability. Let's okay. create a probability.
He won't be able yeah. because he doesn't control the price, and that's that's what he's been saying all night.
Yeah, no,
so
I
the
know.
Price, we don't
like,
determine the price because it could happen up there. It could happen where it's out right now. It can go up a little bit more, but that distribution phase can start up there. It doesn't really have to come down to 155. It can happen up there somewhere.
Very, yeah, that's why I told them. Very good. Very, very, very good. Both you guys. Very, very, very good. Okay. So it could, price could move higher. It can create another support and resistance up in this area here. All right. Starts the distribution phase somewhere up in this area here. Hit support. And then we would close the trade. Or to Daniel's point, okay, so let's say here, so both scenarios is good, but guess what? The bottom line is we don't do anything, right? So that's, we're not closing the trade because guess what? We are still in the markup phase. We haven't hit support. So guess what? We can rest easy, guys. Right, we can rest easy, ride the trend and just make a ton of money. But here is our resistance right here. So we broke that resistance becomes support. Okay, mm-hmm. So resistance becomes support. So let's say price never moved higher, kind of consolidated, came down like this right here. All right, that would be your distribution phase if the price broke support. So let's say it came back down, guys. It came back down from here, right? And then hit this support line right here. This would be our sell signal to get out right here, okay? Mm-hmm. But what will probably happen is that, let's say for instance, it consolidates in here. That's a long support down here. So let's say it consolidates in here. All right, consolidates, never made a new high, didn't make new highs, didn't break this resistance here. Okay, the system will automatically create your support and resistance lines, but you can draw them in too, right? You can draw them in. So let's say right here, price is squeezing right here, never got above the high here, never got above the low here, kind of consolidates like this over through this area here, hits this support line right here. Now we would get a sell signal to get out. Okay, so you guys are mm-hmm. absolutely right. We have to just go along with the price. But guess what? If the price stays here, then we would have to look at this support here or any other support that develops in this mm-hmm. area here. Good job.
In other words, David, you cannot predict. You have to wait, right?
Yes, you cannot predict. You have to wait. Yes, you have to wait. Yeah, you have to wait. Okay. All right, guys. Was this good?
Yeah, amazing. I appreciate it. Thank you. I learned a lot.
Yeah, this is
I pretty keep learning.
You keep learning, right, Daniel? And that's how you learn, right? That's how you learn, right? We keep looking at this. And what happens is this. Especially for new traders, guys, you take all of the guessing, All right, away. All right. And then what happens then? You only focus on what's happening in front of you. The buyers are buying. We want to be buying. Very easy. It's easy, right? It's easy. You go to a store, right? You go to a store, Black Friday, right? Black Friday is very popular, right? Everyone is buying, right? You go to the store and guess what? It's empty. There's no one there, right? There's no one there. Guess what? You're not gonna stay there, right? Right, same thing. We wanna go where the money is. We wanna go where the money is. So they're buying. We wanna be buying with them. When they're done buying, right here, they're done buying, we wanna be done buying too. If they're done buying, look at the Bitcoin example. If they're done buying, why are we buying? If they're done buying, right here, they're done buying, why are we buying? I mean, think about that. I mean, really think about that, right? Right? If they're done buying, if they're no longer buying, why are we buying? When they're out, we want to be out. When they're buying, we want to be buying. Simple. When they're buying, the markup phase, we want to be buying. When they're in the markdown phase, the distribute, when they're done, we want to be done. Simple. That's why the four market phases, that's important. That's why support and resistance is important. All right. Everything else we can fix. All the stuff, even your emotions, right? Trading in the zone, we can fix that. But this right here, if you are selling when they're buying, and if you're buying when they're selling, there's nothing we can do. Yeah, we can't. If you're buying because you think, okay, the price is going lower, I'm getting a cheaper price because it's going lower, and you're buying when they're selling, there's nothing that can fix that. But if we understand we should be buying the markup phase, they're buying, selling, they're selling, we want to get out. All the other stuff, your mindset and everything else, we can fix that. We can fix that. I mean, we've got new traders in this trade here. We've got brand new traders trading for a week and a half, 2 weeks, that are in this trade right here, making money, right? If they sit on the sideline and they're not getting in this trade, there's nothing we can do about that. If they decide to buy in this area here, when they're selling, there's nothing we can do about that. So, I mean, we can take a new trader without a lot of experience and give them all these tools and show them how the markets work, and they follow it, and they'll have a lot more success than individuals who've been trading for a very long time. All right. So I'm going to, look at the time here. Any other questions for me? Any other questions, guys?
I mean, to start a beginner, the monster scalper program that is good for someone that wants to do Forex and crypto and.
Yeah, for monster scalper is our most popular system for cryptos and Forex by far. But I also recommend the coaching too. So we do one-on-one coaching, okay, mm-hmm. on the website. So on our website, let's see here. I don't recommend just getting the system. I recommend doing the one-on-one coaching.
Of course, yes.
First. Let me share it here. Okay. So this is our website here, Monster Trading Systems. And I also recommend coming to the evening classes. We do this every evening. But here are all the systems. We have a wide variety of systems. But the coaching here, we do coaching. We do 4 hours worth of coaching. And then you can get it on Groupon. If you go on Groupon, you get an additional 50% off. Okay, and that's 4 hours worth of coaching. We normally do the coaching on Fridays, but we can schedule anytime. But on Groupon, it's discounted an additional 50%. So I think it's about, right now it's discounted even further. So rather than 240, it's 192 on Groupon, all right? And it's well worth it. It's well worth it.
And that is done only on Fridays?
We normally Fridays, because that's a slow day for the markets. But okay. we can schedule it anytime.
No, that's okay. I'm just like and then it has to be Friday 101 or in the class on Friday that you do.
We do the one-on-one in the office. For local traders, if it's we're here in Orlando, Winter Park, Florida, near Orlando. If you're not in the if traders are not in the area, we do it on Zoom.
So this coaching of 192 is one-on-one.
Yeah, it's one-on-one. It's one-on-one with me. Yeah, one-on-one with
me. So that will be the starting point, just to start with that.
Yeah, I recommend that. Absolutely. Okay. And we give traders the book. You get that book for free, Trading in the Zone. All right. So we get that to you. We ship it out to you. And then we use that as your reference. Okay. So we do 4 weeks. So 1 hour each week. So you get enough time to kind of digest the information, read the book, get the audio book, kind of go through the audio. And by the time you're done with the coaching, you're ready for the markets and you understand the markets and how to trade it properly. Our traders love the one-on-one coaching. If you guys go here on the website, again, monstertradingsystems.com, you guys can go here. Let's see here. You can go to About Us, Testimonials, right here. Testimonials. One second here. Testimonials. Go to the Testimonials page. Hold on. This Zoom is mad. One second here. Okay, there it is here. Okay, so right here, go to the testimonials page. So monstertradingsystems.com/reviews. And we have reviews here from traders on the one-on-one. The traders love the one-on-one coaching. It really gets you ready. All right. And then the systems come next. You don't have to get the systems. If you guys decide to do the one-on-one coaching and you are able to really understand this and pull the trigger, you don't need the systems. Right? I mean, if you understand where to draw your support and resistance lines, you know where to buy, right? But, you know, you want to make it easy. Rather than drawing the lines automatically, the systems will draw the lines. You know, the system will paint the candles for you green. So, you know, you should be buying. It will give you the buy signal, exactly where to buy. We'll send you out an email notification also. I mean, we automate that whole process, but the coaching in itself is well worth it. Get your mind right and understand how trading works. All right.
Yep.
All right. Guys, I want to thank you. We do this class every Tuesday, but again, we have classes every day. Tomorrow, we've got a class on trading in the zone. All right. And then on Thursday, we've got one on stocks and ETFs and options. All right. So I want to thank you guys for taking the time out to learn about trading. You guys made a really good investment in your time. You really did, right? I know we've gone on for a little over an hour now, but it's well worth taking the time out to get in really good information, all right? So I want to applaud you guys, all right? So if you guys need me for anything, just reach out to me. All right. And I look forward to seeing you guys on the next class. All right. Take care. Have a good evening.
Thank you, David. Thank you for your passion. Have a nice night.
Take care. Bye-bye, guys.
Thank you. Bye-bye.